What is it that you think are the good things AI will likely bring to the world? And what are some things that make you maybe worry about AI?
Yeah, so I think it's always important with any new technologies to consider the benefits, the potential benefits, and the potential risks of the technology. So when you think about just the responsibility of a technologist or a scientist, or really anyone, you know, creating new technologies, this is a responsibility. Think about the benefits and to think about the risks. One of the things that I think is just really exciting about this new generation of AI technologies is the huge potential benefit. We've talked about these, you know, this idea of generative AI being more general and more capable of serving so many different downstream uses of the technology. That means I can pick up the same model and use it in a completely different way. You can pick up that model and use it in a way that's meaningful for you. Maybe that's as a tutor for a child learning a new language or learning math or science. And so this is the tremendous, I think, potential upside of these technologies, and we're seeing that play out. But we also have to think about the risks. You know, these AI models, they learn from human expression. They learn from what we're, you know, kind of putting into the world, and that can reflect the best parts of us, and that's what we try to accomplish. It can also affect, kind of reflect things, if we're not careful, that aren't so great. And so that's why, my colleagues and I think very carefully about the safeguards, that go along with these technologies. I think one thing that kind of really motivates me, or animates me in this space is, I want to make sure we're not leaving anyone behind. The generality of the technology means it can support so many uses, but there are, say, people in the world who their language is not yet understood by AI. And so if AI can't, quote unquote, speak your language, you can't necessarily take advantage of it. And so, you know, how do we really think broadly about who can access these technologies and how we can, assure that the benefits of the technology have the broadest possible benefit to society.
So it sounds like you feel that the risks are more in, along the lines of bias and equal access to what you guys see as maybe tools. But I think that for a lot of people like me, that are in a field that certainly can't be replaced at the moment, but looking down the road feels like at least our employees might think that they could replace us, even if they're wrong. So I'm wondering, could you talk a little bit about, other risks of AI in terms of, maybe these companies are, looking at them as tools. How do we keep those, continuing to be tools that workers can use, as opposed to, in a corporate sense, looking at it as, great, I can just replace my worker with this, and then causing all kinds of disruption in society?
Yeah, I think from the standpoint of the people and the companies producing these technologies, I think keeping humans at the center is super important. And first of all, designing the technologies for that complementarity. That's really center, to how the technologies are made. We talk about this idea of the technology as a co-pilot. Then there's ways that the technology can be used and the impact on jobs in the economy. And so I think if you look at the history of technology, there are these new capabilities that come online, and they offer increase in productivity, and they can cause some disruption. And so I think that's something we have to deal with and figure out how we can best support folks, but always thinking about, that complementarity at the end of the day. I think of human beings are tool users. And again, one of the exciting things about this is people will find new ways to use these tools. There will be new, types of human endeavor created, new, businesses and new ways of, in the case of what we're talking about now, new ways of developing art and entertainment and experiences for people. Which for me as a fellow artist, I sort of see art and, as a set of experiences, people create for other people. And the tools we use will change over time. But that, I think of that as a fundamentally human endeavor.